Three of the most common data formats are CSV, XML, and JSON. I want to quickly discuss what one record in the Lahman baseball database would look like in each of these different formats. It just so happens that the first row in this dataset corresponds to a pretty famous baseball player, Hank Aaron. Let's first discuss what this data looks like in the format we originally downloaded it in, CSV. In the CSV format, we usually have a series of rows, with each row corresponding to an entry. There is a header row at the top of our file, where our comma-separated values do not correspond to an entry, but instead tell us what each entry means for the rest of the document. In the case of this baseball document, our first row tells us that every row will have some identifiers, the Lahman ID, the player ID, the manager ID, etc. Then we'll see birth year, birth month, birth day, and then a bunch of other statistics. If we go and look at the entry for Hank Aaron, we see all these values, one for Lahman ID, Aaron HAO1 for player ID, etc., separated by commas. Note that if a particular player doesn't have a value for one field, for example, Hank Aaron does not have a manager ID, we simply see two commas in a row. In the case of an XML document, we end up with something that pretty closely resembles HTML. We can have a document element, which is opened. It can then have a series of tables, which are also opened, as we see here. The table has a number of children, which correspond to the values that we just discussed in the CSV. One for Lahman ID, Aaron HAO1 for player ID, etc. Note that when we're missing a value in XML, things are treated a bit differently. For example, since Hank Aaron was not a manager, we just open the manager ID field and then put a slash at the end. Finally, for a JSON document, we have a number of JSON objects indicated by these curly braces. A JSON object looks a lot like a Python dictionary. We have keys, which correspond to what we would see in the header row in a CSV file, followed by values. Note that in the case of a missing value, we simply open and close the quotation marks. Oftentimes, the benefit of XML or JSON is that they support nested structures in a way that CSV documents cannot. I don't want to go into this in great detail, but you can imagine that the value corresponding to a particular JSON key, say Braves, could itself be another JSON object. Here's what that might look like. One final note is to remember that when we talk about different formats that data can come in, it's not a matter of the file extension being .csv or being .json. A file format really has to do with how the data is organized inside of a file. So we could easily have data that is formatted in JSON or CSV, but that comes in a file whose extension is .txt. Since the online MTA subway data comes in CSV format, and the Weather Underground API responds to requests with a JSON object, we'll discuss how to load and process files in these two formats. While we won't explicitly discuss loading and processing XML files, it isn't that different than the material we'll cover with regards to JSON and CSV. If you'd like to learn more about dealing with XML data in particular, I'd recommend you take the data wrangling class with MongoDB taught here at Udacity. For now, let's discuss how to work with CSV files.